Hey Faith family, it's Brother Mario. I wanted to go ahead and do a video here to answer a biblical question that is so important for us to fully comprehend exactly what the Bible says. And that is, can a practicing homosexual become a born-again Christian and saved? Now, the reason that this is so highly debated today is because, well, we have people on both sides. On one extreme, we have people who, like this Westboro Baptist, believe that every single person who displays homosexual attraction is a reprobate. They are already damned to hell, hopeless, and there's really no point in trying to reach them with the gospel, sharing your testimony, or extending love to them. They're repulsive pigs. This is the mindset of some very lost people out there. Then on the other side, there are very liberal Christians who, in a form of lawlessness, are going to say that, well, it's okay for me to be a practicing homosexual and to love Jesus. I can continue in my sin of homosexuality and still have a relationship with God. Both of them are in complete error, and I'm going to show you today what the Bible actually does say. So let's go ahead and get right into it. Now, the key passage in order to understand this is actually found in 1 Corinthians chapter 6. And now if we go to verse 9, it says, "Do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived." And then it goes on to list those who aren't going to go into God because of go to heaven because of unrighteousness. It says, "Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor idolaters, nor men who practice homosexuality, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you." See that? "And some were some of you. But you were washed, you were sanctified, and you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God." And so here we see in this that there are people, homosexuals, adulterers, greedy, drunkards, revilers, thieves, every single one of us are sinners in one way, shape, or fashion. And so we all must be made new. And you see, as some were some of you. And so we see by that very communication and way of expressing that there is a transformation that occurs in the life of a believer, where we are washed and sanctified and transformed. And we see this all over in the Bible, how all things in Christ are new. You become a new creature, a new person. So that is why those who say that I can continue in this sin of homosexuality and still be a Christian, I have to argue from this verse, it is very clear that a true Christian is someone who was practicing the sin of homosexuality and is no longer practicing that. You, if you are now indwelt with the Holy Spirit, you will be convicted of sin. And the Holy Spirit will also lead you into the truth of the Scripture, of the Word of God. And no matter how much the culture and political correctness tries to impress upon you to say that homosexuality is okay, that it's natural, you will be convicted by the Spirit of God and led by His Spirit into the truth that it is not, in order to be transformed into the new creature that God has called you into becoming. And so that's the one side. Now, those on the other side, these extremists, I can already hear you in the comment section. Yes, I can hear you already with your insane little pathetic lies and manipulative tactics to try and push your hateful nonsense. And let me just address it. So what they're going to go ahead and do, there's a group of very hateful preachers out there and people who inside of themselves want to look down on homosexuals, call them reprobate and hate them. They often come, and they're King James only, the most of them, in these kind of little weird Baptist cults. And they come and they say, well, look, in the King James, it doesn't say homosexual. Now, let's go ahead and read that. nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you, but ye are washed, and ye are sanctified, and ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God. So you see, Mario, you see, when you follow the King James only, which is the only Bible in existence that every single human being on the earth needs to follow, including you, Frenchman Mario, who didn't even know English until you were in grade 4. And yes, all you Chinese-speaking, Italian-speaking, every language in the world, you must bow to the altar of English dominance, and you must study old archaic English in order to interpret the Bible correctly. Don't do the mistake of going to the actual original manuscripts of Greek and Hebrew. No, 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 no. You can't do that. You must bow to English only, cult-like mentality to enable hatred. No, 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 no. My little King James only possible cult-like hater. Go sit down in the corner. It's enough of your nonsense. I'm going to put you in your place here, son. The original manuscripts are written in Greek. Okay? They're not written in Old English. And what you will hear is hate preachers who want to justify this type of hatred towards those, and they want to spew their disgusting hate. What they're going to do is say, well, no, you can't go back to the Greek because you don't know the Greek, Mario. Well, guess what, buddy? I don't know archaic Old English. Do you not know that no one talks like this? Ye, they, thou? Did you clue in that in order for me, a Frenchman who barely could comprehend the English language learning when I grew up, je parlais like this for a long time, I talked with an accent and it took me a long time to not, okay, so I'm not going to learn Old English. Enough with your nonsense, okay? Guys, the actual word that is used in the Greek, which the apostles used, okay, they didn't use English, okay, was arsenokeotes. And yes, I can't pronounce it, but I also can't pronounce 90 of the words in the archaic language of Old English that the King James Version is written in, okay? So you're going to hear these hate preachers say, well, we'll go up to these guys, like, they'll accuse me of being a scholar, of being someone who's using, I guess I'm too logical and reasonable for these guys, so they gotta, oh, yeah, go stump them with this logic. And they'll say, well, go ask him if he understands Greek. Well, do you understand old archaic English? No, you don't. And if you did, it's because you've been reading it and you've been practicing it, just like you could have with Greek. So, guys, stop with the insanity. If we're going to do things, let's do them logically and use our brains that God had given us, and common sense. The manuscripts are in Greek. I, as a Frenchman, do not need to learn English. I can go from French to Greek, from Chinese to Greek, from Chinese to Hebrew, from Chinese to Greek, from Italian to Greek. We don't need to all the other languages. Go to you English people, to understand the proper interpretation of Scripture. You are so insane and ridiculous for making such a claim that other language people need to learn Old English KJV to have the proper interpretation, because the KJV interpretation of the Bible is more accurate than the actual manuscripts themselves. Do you see this? Oh, this is so stupid. Dumb. And anyone who tells you that and says that they're preaching in the name of God is dumb, and God's not stupid. Okay? So let's see what it actually says. Arsenokeos is, in the actual definition of it, a homosexual. And you actually find that this is in the book of Leviticus, used to describe homosexuals. You shall not lie with a male as with a woman. It is an abomination. And what is the word that is used? The same one that is used in the verse that is in question here in 1 Corinthians chapter 6. Okay? And over it is used in other examples in the scripture which show the proper interpretation of the old Greek word that is actually used in the real manuscripts is a homosexual, a sodomite. Okay? So what the Bible is saying is that a homosexual, a sodomite, is possible to be saved. They are not damned forever like some cultic hate preachers, Baptist Westboro nonsense, fake wolves in sheep's clothing would like to hate preach you, brainwash you into desiring. Let me tell you something. If you buy into this, if you right now are sitting there and you've actually swallowed the lie that homosexuals cannot be saved, you want to know why? There's something wrong with you. We accumulate teachers in accordance to our own desires. There is something really sick that you desire to see humans hated on like this? You like putting yourself up on a pedestal and hating on other people and wishing them to hell and condemning them and feeling so self-righteous? Yeah, that's why you got those teachers spewing those hated, those lies into you. Okay? Wake up. Homosexuals can get saved, and we should preach to them. We have a responsibility now more than ever to reach them, because the Bible is clear. Do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor arsenokono whatevers. Okay? The actual use word in the Greek. Don't fall for the KGV-only cult lies that are spewed out there. Nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you. But you were washed, you were sanctified, and you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. God can transform even the homosexual. No questions asked. Anyone who tells you otherwise is a ravenous, lying, hateful preacher. Have yourself a blessed and wonderful day. Stay vigilant. Fear no evil.